I am Udoy Bhans. Welcome to you to your favorite YouTube channel, Udoy Bhans English or Learn English with Udoy Bhans. Today, I shall not teach you English, but I shall teach you something and that is quite familiar nowadays in the present society or in the modern society. And what is it? The topic is, if you have wit, if you have wit, you are the daughter. If not, you are the daughter-in-law. Once again, if you have wit, you are the daughter. If not, you are the daughter-in-law. How is it possible? Because nowadays, most of the family members say that their mother-in-laws are not good. And the mother-in-laws say that daughter-in-laws are not good. So what is the reason of their misunderstanding, quarreling and fighting? According to mine, perhaps I have no lots of experience regarding this, but I have especially collected some of the experiences, and from my experience point of view, I am going to tell you what are the points for which there is misunderstanding between the daughter-in-law and mother-in-law. Point number one, the elderly persons need respect. The elderly persons need respect. That means mother-in-law must be an elderly person. But in case of Nagoda, I have read from the newspaper that there is a grandmother and her age is, or she is 35 years of her age. But in our society, it can't happen. So as mother-in-laws are the elderly persons, they need respect. So all the daughter-in-laws are advised to give respect to them, because you are entitled to give respect to them. Why? You might have asked me why. The reason is, second point will tell you the reason. And what is the reason? The reason is, the daughter-in-laws need love. That means the mother-in-laws need respect. The daughter-in-laws need love. That means, if a mother-in-law does not get respect from a daughter-in-law, she will not provide her love to her daughter-in-law. So it is my request to all the mother-in-laws, at first, to provide love to their daughter-in-laws. And it is also my request to the daughter-in-laws that they must respect their mother-in-laws, because they are elderly persons. They need only respect. And if you respect them, you will get love. On the contrary, if you get love, or if the mother-in-laws provide love, they will get respect. So the mother-in-laws should give or provide love to their daughter-in-laws, and the daughter-in-laws must get respect from their, the daughter-in-laws must give respect to their elderly persons, that means to their mother-in-laws. Point number three, do not try to expose one another. Do not try to expose one another. I have seen that in the absence of daughter-in-law, the mother-in-law speaks against her. And in the absence of mother-in-law, the daughter-in-law speaks against her. And if it happens, the person whom you are speaking or the person whom you are talking against, your daughter-in-law or mother-in-law, that person, that means the time will come, that person will tell to that particular person that, yes, your daughter-in-law has told me so, or your mother-in-law has told me so. So, as a result of which, bitter feelings arise in the minds of the mother-in-laws and in the minds of the daughter-in-laws. So, we mustn't expose one another. Point number three. Do not talk against one another. In the presence also. In the presence. That means everyone should try to bear one another's presence. And in the presence also, they should not talk against themselves. That means the daughter-in-law should not talk something or should not talk something against the mother-in-law, and the mother-in-law should not talk or speak anything against the daughter-in-law. Next, point number five. Spend time together as much as possible. That means both these sister-in-laws and mother-in-laws, they should think that they are mothers and daughters. And if they have such types of feelings, they can spend much time together. As a result of which, there will be no disturbance between mother-in-law and daughter-in-law. Next, study one another. Study one another means try to know the mentality of one another. That means the daughter-in-law should know the mentality of mother-in-law. On the contrary, the mother-in-law should know the mentality of daughter-in-law. Next point. Tackle the situation means sometimes bad situations may arise. Whatever the situation may be, as a clever person, the daughter-in-law should tackle the situation. And as an experienced person, the mother-in-law should tackle the situation. And that is known as tackle the situation. Next point. Avoid short-temper and bad-temper mentality. Avoid short-temper and bad-temper mentality. That means, short-temper means the persons who get angry at once, and they are called short-tempered persons. And bad-tempered means the persons who get angry without understanding anything. Once again, bad-tempered means the persons who get angry without understanding anything. So, short-tempered means the persons who get angry at once. Bad-tempered means the persons who get angry without understanding the fact. Okay. So, avoid short-temper and bad-temper mentality. That means avoid short-temper and bad-temper mentality. That means both the mother-in-law and the sister-in-law should keep themselves far away from short-temper and bad-temper mentality. Finally, give priority to the team spirit. Give priority. Priority means prominence. Prominence means importance. That means importance should be given to the team spirit. Team spirit means The mother-in-law should think that all the family members are the members of a team. And the daughter-in-law should think that all the family members are the members of a team. And if there is a team spirit, there will be no disturbance. Perhaps I think that I have given a short piece of information to you regarding the controversy, its origin, and regarding its solution. If this channel is or will be useful to you, please like, share, comment, follow, and subscribe it. Thank you.